In this session, we are going to examine a beam analysis problem posed by a student. Suppose we have a beam subjected to a point load and a uniformly distributed load like this. How do we come up with its shear force and bending moment equations? In addition to solving this problem, in this video, I'm going to introduce an interactive tool that we have developed for our students, for you, so you can check your own work when formulating shear and moment equations. The tool is an interactive document that you can download and run offline on your desktop computer. To download it, go here. I will show you how it works at the end of the lecture, after we are done solving this problem. To start, we need to calculate the beam's support reactions. First, let's draw its free body diagram. Note the unknown reaction forces shown on the diagram. We need two equilibrium equations in order to be able to calculate these unknown forces. The sum of the forces in the y direction must be zero. The sum of the bending moments about point B must be zero. Solving these equations for the unknowns, we get 2.5 kilonewtons for Cy and 13.5 kilonewtons for By. To write the shear and moment equations, we need to cut the beam at several places along its length. The load and support reactions divide the beam into three segments, AB, BC, and CD. Therefore, we need to cut the beam three times, once in each segment, resulting in three distinct free body diagrams. Let's assume that the origin of the coordinate system is placed at point A. Since we are not cutting the beam at a specific point, rather, we are cutting it at an arbitrary point, we are going to refer to the distance from the origin to the cut point as x. For the first segment, x is between 0 and 2 meters. For the second segment, x varies between 2 and 6 meters. And for the third segment, x lies in between 6 and 8 meters. At the cut point, we have a shear force and a bending moment. We label them Vx and Mx respectively. This notation suggests that the shear and moment at an arbitrary point in the beam can be written in terms of x. That is, the shear and moment equations are functions of x. Using each of these diagrams, we can write a shear equation and a moment equation for each beam segment. For the segment in which x is between 0 and 2 meters, we can write the sum of the forces in the y direction and set it to zero. This gives us an expression in terms of Vx. Now, let's write the moment equilibrium equation about the cut point. Here, we get an equation in terms of Mx. For the middle segment, where x is between 2 and 6 meters, the shear and moment equations can be written in a similar manner. When we sum up the forces in the y direction, we get the shear equation. And when we sum up the moments about the cut point, we get the moment equation. For the third segment, we get the shear equation and this moment equation. Simplifying these shear and moment equations, we get... In summary form, we can write the shear equation for the entire beam as a piecewise function. Like this. The moment equation can be written in a similar manner. Now, let's validate our calculations using the interactive document that I mentioned a few minutes ago. On a desktop computer, the document appears like this. It has four tabs at the top. The first tab is for the problem definition page. Here, we define the parameters for the beam that we wish to analyze. Our beam has a length of 8 meters. The left support is located 2 meters from the left end of the beam. The right support is placed 2 meters from the right end of the beam. The beam is subjected to a point load at 10 kilonewtons at x equals 0. and there is a uniformly distributed load with a magnitude of 3 kilonewton meters placed 6 meters to the right of the origin. The second tab takes us to the support reactions page. Here, we can verify our equilibrium equations formulation and check the resulting support reaction values. The third tab opens the shear and moment equations page. On this page, we can pick a beam segment from the drop-down menu to view its free body diagram and shear and moment equations. The fourth tab is for viewing the shear and moment diagrams and their peak values. Feel free to use this interactive document for validating your work when formulating shear and moment equations and drawing their corresponding diagrams. The tool works for any simply supported beam that adheres to the parameters and constraints specified on the problem definition page.